Hello guys, this is the fifth video from the course 3D Camera Animation and Rigging Techniques. In this tutorial, you will learn how to do camera walkthrough animation by attaching a camera through a spline using a walkthrough assistant. This is a simple scene where we will be doing a walkthrough animation. First, we will create a path using a line where the camera will move. Try to create a smooth line, especially at the corners. For ease of use, I will change my selection filters to shapes. I will go to line and I will click here. Now, let's say I want my animation to start from here. My persons are moving like this, so I want my camera to move something like this. Then I will click somewhere here, then I will click here, and I want to end it at the door, so I will click here. Now it's time to make our curve smooth. First of all, I will go to the line and I will click on adaptive. Make sure this is on. Now go to your vertex. Select this and change it into Bezier and adjust it like this. For this part, I will first go and do a refine here, somewhere here, so that I can add another point here. Change this type to Bezier and I will reset it, something like this. Then I will again come here, right click, refine, and I will add another point here. I will put something like this and I will change it into Bezier and I will reset it. Now for this kind of sharp corners, I can make it a Bezier, but I will prefer to go to the geometry and click on fillet and do it like this. Undo it. Just take it a little bit more towards here and then again fillet it. I've seen that it works a lot better like this. But again, you can do it just by the Bezier. Fillet and just do it like this a little bit. Now for this part, go into your perspective viewport, and now first of all I will click on the line and I will take it to the height where I want it. I put it right now on the floor. Click on the vertex, press F3 on the keyboard, click here and move it up all the way till here like this. Again, move it all the way up here like this. Now I want to click on refine and I want to add another point here. Press T on the keyboard and I will take it somewhere like this. Again, another refine and I will put it something like this. P for perspective again, and again I will bring it little bit up here like this and make sure this one is also on the edge like this. Now click here, right click and change it into Bezier. Take it a little bit back if you want. Again, change it into Bezier and something like this. Again, and on this one, press F3 on the keyboard, and you can again reset them if you think they are not okay, not according to your need. Keep perspective and press F3. Now you can see that I got this curve, a smooth curve like this. I will do some more little bit work on this curve and then I will come back again. And in the end, you can place it at the top like this. So guys, this is the final curve that I have created for this path. After you have completed your line, or you can say your path, then you have to go to your camera, and this time again you have to create a free camera, not a target camera. I am using V-Ray physical camera, but you can use 3ds Max standard camera. After this, go to modify, uncheck target, and you can also turn on automatic vertical tilt. Now left click here and press C on the keyboard. Once you have made your path and you have created a camera, then you have to go to your animation and click on walkthrough assistant. Walkthrough assistant is extremely simple. You can create a new camera from here, or you can use an existing camera like this one. Then you have to click on pick path and you have to pick your path. Next, after this you have to come here, and my initial angle is not set. You can see my camera is facing somewhere here. So this is left and right turn of the camera. So I will turn my camera something like this. I will align my camera to the path. You can see I have aligned my camera to the path. Now play the animation. And remember one more thing. If I choose my camera, again, just like the previous video, we have two keyframes, one at the start of the timeline and one at the end of the timeline. We can change them too. But first, we will gonna play this animation. You can see that my camera is right now rotating like this. There are some jerks in it, but we will set it later. Okay, now pause it. Go back. If you see it in the top viewport, if I just select my camera in my top viewport like this, and now if I play my animation, you can see that the camera is perfectly aligned with the path and it is following the path rotation, because this follow path option is on by default in the camera. If this option is on, the camera will follow the path rotation. But I want to change the rotation of the camera. For that, I have to click on auto key. Plus, I normally turn off follow path because I find it easy to set my rotations like this. Uncheck it, close it. Go back to the first frame. Now guys, make sure your auto key is on and your camera is selected. I will change my camera somewhere like this. I want my camera to start like this. I want it to go straight like this. I want my camera to be a little bit like this. Then I want my camera to move a little bit like this. And as it is coming close, I want it to look a little bit towards this side further. Just slight, not too much, little bit. So now when my camera starts, it starts looking at this side towards this person, and then I want it to look towards the other side. So I will click here and I will change it like this. Something like this. So now again go back and drag your timeline. Now At this point, I wanted to totally look towards this straight side like this. Now again, drag it back. And at frame 350, I wanted to look more towards the left, towards these ones. Let's leave it, delete it, and somewhere here, I wanted to look like towards this side. Oops, I'm not satisfied like this. I wanted to look little bit more towards this side for little bit long, and then when it he is around about to pass this guy, I want it to look towards this side like this. So again, go back and play your animation. You can see it's looking towards this side and it is turning its head like this. Yeah, this is something that I want it now to look towards the left side like this. And now I want it till here, I want it to keep looking towards those three men like this. Now I want him to, at this point I want him to look all the way towards the right. So again, I will change it. Now you can see that since my auto key is on, whenever I am rotating or changing this thing, they are also moving like this. And then I want him to look little bit straight like this. Again, I want him to keep looking at this side little bit longer, and then I want him to turn towards this side like this. And at the last frame, I want him to totally look towards the inside part, this. Now I will again scrub my timeline. To make sure and see I'm getting everything the way I want. Now go back to the first frame and play the animation. Plus remember one more thing guys, this is tilt head. If I want my guy to look little bit up, something at any point, like at this point, I want him to first look, I want him to keep look at this part. Let's say I want him to look up. I can increase my tilt something like this too. So now, when he's turning like this, he will look up, and then I want him to keep looking at this part. Click on key mode toggle, click on previous key so that I'm on this key. I can see its value. I will copy this value and I will just want him to keep looking for few more frames here like this on the top. Now guys, if I go little bit back and I play my animation again, nope, I don't like this thing, so I can delete its keys. I don't like it to be up, but you can do it if you want. And then again, play the animation. See guys, this is how you can animate it. And remember a few more things. If you want to remove all the keys, you can simply remove it like this, and all of your keys will be deleted. If you want to set another camera, you can set it from here, something like this, and the other things. So guys, I have paused my video for a few minutes and I have just worked on my path and little bit on the camera. Remember, it's a non-destructive workflow, so you can change your path and camera at any time. And this is my final animation what I have made. I will provide its link in the description so that you can easily download it and you can see how I created my path and my keyframes. So guys, I hope you like this tutorial. If you like it, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating, guys. Bye bye.